We're hitting the open road to decarbonization. We're traveling across the U.S. to visit Better Climate Challenge partner plants and buildings to highlight their innovative solutions to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Our first stop, Nashville, Tennessee. Rooftop bar, great food, great view, beautiful day, and live music in the background. Don't get much better than that.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Before we waste too much time here, we should probably figure out where we're heading.
Oh yeah, let's take our orders from Maria.
Hi, John and Sachin. Today, you'll be heading just outside Chattanooga to get the full efficiency story on the Whirlpool facility in Cleveland, Tennessee. Whirlpool is all in on decarbonization, and through their world-class manufacturing program, they're finding some new and different ways to cut waste. So have fun. I know you will, because there's a lot to see.
Excellent. We're heading to Whirlpool.
Yeah, Whirlpool in Cleveland, Tennessee. At least we are not going to Cleveland, Ohio, John.
Cleveland, Ohio might be a little bit too much time in the car with you.
Hey, but 2 hours of music. So maybe this time we play country music.
Whirlpool is a $20 billion home appliance company. This plant you're in today is one of our two cooking facilities. So world-class manufacturing is our main production system. It consists of 10 pillars, one of which is energy and environmental pillars. So that is our execution engine for most of our energy efficiency projects. We are a strong believer in renewable energy. In fact, 5 of our facilities in the U.S. use on-site wind. In the U.S., we just recently signed our second VPPA, which the two combined will provide 400,000 megawatt hours to the ERCOT grid, which is enough to cover 100% of our U.S. operations and well on our way to meeting both net zero and the Better Climate Challenge.
Oh my goodness, look at it, all LED lights. This is like all energy efficiency everywhere.
Yes, absolutely. We recently installed the LED lights and we were able to save over $291,000 a year.
Oh, wow.
With this installation.
That's impressive.
So this is our training facility. This is where new hires are brought. This is our energy station and I've got a fun little game. So which of you guys is strongest?
Let's see. I think it's Sacha.
We have 3 light bulbs. Which one of these do you think is going to take the most power to get going?
I think LED will go on first.
Yes.
Okay, and then fluorescent, and then last one will be incandescent. Oh man, this is hard to do. This is a lot of power.
Yeah, no kidding.
Oh, look at that. So easy.
Yeah, I know.
Oh my goodness, I'm just using my fingers in this case, not even muscles.
So you are right, strongest and the smartest.
Strongest and smartest, okay. I'm going to remember now forever, like incandescent takes a lot of power.
Once a year we do a Kaizen Power Pitch competition where some of our best projects are brought forward and we compete against other plants within the Whirlpool network.
What different criteria you actually use to select specific projects for that competition?
We look at savings, we look at adherence to the process, and we look at any interesting technologies that are deployed.
So not just friendly competition, but collaboration and knowledge sharing too.
We have 26 tuggers on our fleet currently of hydrogen fuel cells. We have 16 reach trucks, and we have over 50 forklifts on the way.
Oh, wow. The hydrogen's a whole lot better because pretty much it charges as you're working versus with the electric, you have to stop working, actually plug it up to the charger and wait for it to fully charge. With the hydrogen, it continues to charge as you're working. So all I have to do is reach over, hit the start button, it does everything else.
That's great, that's very easy. And in how much time it takes to do this?
3 to 5 at the max.
3 to 5 minutes?
Yeah, depending on whether it's a tugger or a stand-up reach.
And so, yeah, within 3 to 5 minutes, you are ready to go.
So pretty soon, all of their vehicles on site will be fully powered by green hydrogen and totally decarbonized.
Once they develop more and more confidence in green hydrogen, they can even go for using green hydrogen in their furnaces.
This looks like we're in the mechanical room. What systems do you have here?
Well, right now we've got chillers, which we cool the water for the plant. Behind us, you'll see air compressors with the press air. And then right over here, we have boilers, which we heat water, heat the plant, and heat water for the washer. We did a Kaizen on the power pitch and did all the calculations so that we could justify the controller. And what we found out that we could save $35,000 a year by having better controls and sequencing the compressors in. So this controls all four. We can see our air pressure, we can see how much air we're using, and it also gives you graphs where you can see what's happened in the history.
So this is our compressed air dashboard. I wanted to show it to you. On the left, you can see all four of our compressors and their current status. Right now, only number three is running. We have implemented a compressed air leak survey with some ultrasound equipment that we had purchased. We had purchased a UltraProbe 9000, and one of the uses of that is we are able to go through the plant and search for leaks with ultrasound.
So as you are fixing compressed air leaks, like live on this dashboard, you're actually seeing that your CAPM, your overall efficiency actually improving.
Absolutely.
That is very impressive.
This furnace is our largest user of natural gas in the facility, and we are investigating heat capture from these furnaces to actually use in place of one of the boilers for those washers.
So they're already looking at different type of losses. They're trying to reduce those losses and increase energy efficiency. And I think they also talked about decarbonization opportunities, right?
Yeah, they did. So it sounds like they're looking at the possibility of electrification of those furnaces. Definitely a lot of challenges, it sounds like, still. But it's really interesting that they're looking into it both here and at sister plants as well. So Sachin, what did you think about the three partners we saw this week?
Yeah, we went to Nissan, Chemours, and Whirlpool. All three different type of manufacturers. Their decarbonization solutions are different. Their challenges are different.
But a lot of different solutions too. And we've got a lot of really smart people at our partners working to find the solutions to this problem.
In the end, it's all about people, John.
Yeah, you got that right. I'm really gonna miss this city.
Yeah, me too.
Come on, Asheville.
Until next time.